KCTCS, transforming lives, transforming Kentucky.
Today on the hot seat, Jeanine Edwards. Oh, yeah, Jeanine Edwards. One of the things I want you to know that you may not know, she's from New Jersey. She's a animal lover, but she also was an apprentice jockey. Now, you know she does.
More about me than I
know. Yeah, that's right. And you know, here's the funny thing. She's good at basketball. She loves that horse thing. And in our state, you people probably know her more than anyone else in her profession because of the horses. But let me ask you a question. Jeanine.
I'm impressed with your research.
How about that? How about you're in a sport dominated by men? How is it for women? How hard is it for a woman to break through?
Cal, that is a stupid question. I mean, how hard do you think it is? I
must have hit a nerve. Did I hit a nerve? I must have hit a nerve here.
I'm outnumbered 99 to 1. How hard do you think it is? I mean, I got nobody to hang out with.
What a great response. I mean, how about being nice? You see all the teams. Let's not talk about us. What other teams? Give me four teams that you say, let's talk about these four. Who would they be?
Ooh, okay, I'd say Vanderbilt.
Why do you like them?
You know, they are, in my opinion, very well coached.
Yeah.
Good game plan. They seem to be able to take other teams' strengths away from them. I think Mississippi State, you know, another team that I think is very well coached. And, of course, Venardo is just such a weapon. And Tennessee, you can never overlook Tennessee. What they've done after losing four of their best and their highest scorers, what they've done since January 1st, I guess I'd have to throw Mississippi in there.
That's what I would say.
Yeah, I guess I'd have to throw Mississippi in there. Am I close?
I would say the four that you mentioned. But Arkansas has come on.
Well, that's true.
They've done good things.
Yeah,
Alabama's done things. Georgia, I'm just telling you, they're dangerous. They may be a team in the tournament that goes and busts through.
I kind of fell in love with horse racing around the age of 10 or 12 when, you know, we had the back-to-back Triple Crown winners with Affirmed in Seattle Slew. And I've always loved horses as a kid, never had my own horse. My parents were appalled when I said I wanted to work at the racetrack. They were like, you are not going to the racetrack. But I ended up spending 10 years on the racetrack, riding and training racehorses, mostly in New York, Belmont, Saratoga, and Aqueduct. And just loved it. But when I got married, we moved. It was kind of time for a change. And I just sort of got into the TV end of horse racing coverage.
Let's talk about the top three horses that you think the Derby this year.
Oh, gosh. Well, you know, there are some nice horses. The season is just kind of starting to find its way. Now you've got the champion two-year-old Looking at Luck, trained by Bob Baffert in California. He is the real deal. He's a very, very nice horse. There's a horse that's been based in Maryland. His name is Tempted to Tap It. He is going to run next weekend, and we'll see. He's never run in a stakes race yet. See where he fits into the deal. And then there's, you know, a couple others like Rule. Rule is a very nice horse. He's owned by the people from Windstar Farm in Lexington. And he won a stakes last weekend very impressively. He looks like he's the real deal. So there's three names for you. Not necessarily favorites.
Wow. Not favorites,
but don't hold me to it, please.
This is on tape. That's the greatest thing. I will not pick a horse. I do not want to do that to anyone.
I do not bet. I mean, I'll have my picks who I like here and there, but I don't like to put
money. Well, I've got to say this to you before we go. That's the dumbest question you could... What are you talking about? Jeanine Edwards, having fun on the hot seat.
It's been fun, Cal. Just don't do that to me on ESPN. That's all I ask.